Artificial respiration is indicated when respiration stops but heart continues to beat. And the indications are newborn babies, drowning, poisoning by various gases, and anesthetic complications. Artificial respiration can be performed either by manual methods or by machines like respirator or resuscitator. But in case of emergency, manual methods can be performed immediately. Artificial respiration is performed in children at a rate of about 25 to 35 per minute and in adult at about 12 to 20 per minute. Starting with methods of artificial respiration. In children and adults, we can perform Skepper's prone pressure method, Sylvester method, Holger, Nelson push and pull method, and mouth-to-mouth respiration. In infants and newborn babies, we can perform mouth-to-mouth respiration, Sylvester method, as well as pinching the skin and splashing hot and cold water alternatively also is effective. Let us start with Skepper's prone pressure method. Place the patient in prone position. One arm is extended over the head and the other arm is bent at the elbow. Head of the patient is turned towards one side. Wipe out the mucus or other secretions from the mouth. Kneel down near the upper end of the patient's thigh. Place your palm, thumb and fingers in natural position with tip of your finger slightly bent and little finger just touching the lower rib. With arms held straight, swing forward slowly so that weight of your body is gradually brought to bear on the patient. Without bending elbow, continue to swing forward till your arms are vertical. Now swing backward immediately and release the pressure completely without removing your hands from the patient's back. Repeat the procedure at required rate. Next is Sylvester's method. This method is performed in the patients who cannot be placed in prone position due to injuries as well as in pregnant females. Place the patient in supine position. Raise the chest and extend the neck by placing a roll of clothing or pillow under the scapula. Kneel down at a comfortable distance from the patient's head, facing his or her feet. Grasp the forearm of the patient and carry them backward and upward over his or her head as far as they can go. Maintain this position for about 2 seconds. Then carry the arms forward and downward against his or her ribs, applying steady progressive pressure on the front side of the chest for about 2 seconds. Repeat the cycle at required rate. Next is Holger Nelson's push and pull method. It is the second most effective method for artificial respiration. For this, place the subject in prone position, bend the elbow of the subject. And keep the head rotated one side. Remove the mucus from the mouth. Then kneel down near the head of the subject at comfortable distance from the subject. Place your hands flat on subject's back below the armpit. Your thumbs barely touching his body. Fingers spread downward and outward. Then rock forward slowly, keeping elbow straight until your arms are near vertical. Here we are exerting a steady downward pressure. Now rock backward, releasing the pressure. Slide your hands outward to grasp the subject's arm just above the elbow. As you continue to swing backward, raise and pull subject's arm towards you till you feel a tension in his shoulder. Then repeat the procedure at indicated rate. Next is mouth-to-mouth respiration. For that, extend patient's head by placing pillow under the scapula. Then clean the mouth and keep the thin cloth over his lips. Pinch his or her nostril with one hand and grasp his lower jaw with other hand between thumb and index finger. Lift the jaw and keep the mouth open and take a deep breath and blow air into patient's mouth until his chest expands. Repeat the cycle at indicated rate. Mouth-to-mouth respiration is the best method of artificial respiration. Thank you.